This post is inspired by R4DS book club meeting earlier, which happened quite long time ago. The chapter was about factors, the forecast package. And the question arose, why do we need to re-level factors? This book, R4 Data Science, presents how to do factor re-leveling, but it doesn't answer why we should do it. So I prepared a post. I wanted to create a blog post about it and share it here, but somehow the blog down package was not working. Some issues are happening with GitHub and blog down package. There are some conflicts. So I'm presenting it right here. I am preparing it in R Markdown. So we will have to first load the required packages. The AER package, that is Applied Econometrics with R, is a book written by Akeem Zillis. And this package has some methods and even the data sets required. Hi, Meenakshi.
Hi, Malik. How are you?
How are you?
Pretty good, thank you.
New participant, Apruti, is actually my friend. She's a doctoral student.
Oh, okay. And
she was trying to do panel data analysis, but she was unable to do it in her statistical major. She was trying to get the key views, but the correct version was also not available. And the institute was not offering it just for that. So she's trying to learn everything in R, from basics to panel data analysis.
Oh, great. Then this book club is great. Welcome, Akriti. Nice to meet you.
And I thought no one was coming, so I took it to myself to present a factor re-leveling.
Okay, sure. That's a great topic.
Yes, actually, this topic arose when we were discussing factors. Arnab was making that presentation.
Mm-hmm.
This book presents how to do the factor re-leveling.
Hi,
but... can you mute yourself? Akruti, can you mute yourself? So, the AER package is required for data set, and tidyverse and Broom for processing the regression and other aspects. Now we will first explore the data using the summary so that we can just understand what kind of data is stored in the data set. You can see that base is a numeric data, but other than that, education, experience, age is also numeric, but experience is a factor. There are different factor levels, gender, occupation, sector, union, etc. There are many factor variables in this data set. Ethnicity, region, gender, occupation, sector, union, and merit. All that factor variables only. They have different levels. They are coded here as numeric, but in reality, they are factors. For this exercise, we are focusing on ethnicity, which has three levels. The Caucasian, Hispanic, and others. And we will see if there is any difference in weight with respect to ethnicity. This means, is there any statistically significant difference in weight when the ethnicity changes, so we filter only select the two variables which are required for this analysis, ethnicity and income. We have created kind of a pivot table by using group by and summarize. So mean wage is only for Caucasian, the mean wage is 8. Hispanic it is 5.2 and for others there is 7.5. So we can clearly see that there is some difference between Caucasian and Hispanic, 8.0 versus 5.2. So there is some difference. But is this statistically significant? We can even use a digit plot the difference between the wages. We have created a bar chart here, wage by ethnicity. And there is some clear difference to it. And now we can focus whether this is statistically significant or not. Because there are three categories, we will have to do ANOVA. We cannot do pairwise t-testing here. Otherwise, we will have to probably do three t-tests in this case. So ANOVA says, yes, there is some statistically significant difference between these two because of this. There is some difference, yes. This ANOVA value states only that there is statistically significant difference, but which group is different, we cannot know from here. We will have to perform a post hoc analysis for that. There are some variations in the post hoc analysis. We are focusing on Tukey HSD test for this. There is Bonferroni test as well, but we are not doing it here. Both will give same result as such. So Tukey HSD gives this result here. The command is Tukey HSD and then into bracket all the ANOVA command, AOV. And we can see here wherever Caucasian is involved, the p-value is almost similar. But when Caucasian is not, that means in the third line, when others and Hispanic, then p-value is quite different from 0.12 and 0.16 to straightway 0.78. And even in the difference also, when Caucasian is involved, it's in negative. But now when Caucasian is not involved, then the difference is positive. So we can see that Caucasian is definitely different from the rest of the two groups. So this Tukey HSD shows that difference is negative. I have summarized the same thing here. When Caucasian is involved, it is statistically significant from the rest of the two ethnicities. But how much is the difference? We can get it through regression. On average, right now if we see, because the ethnicity is a factor, there are two categories. Reference is the Caucasian and only other two ethnicities are shown here, Hispanic and others. So if we want to answer here, on average, Hispanic person gets minus 1.99 less wage. I mean, the wage earned by this Hispanic category person is less than the Caucasian by 1.99, whichever the unit. I think it is dollar per hour. So if that is the unit, it means that almost $2, Hispanic person earns almost $2 less than Caucasian per hour. And a person belonging to other ethnicity earns $1.21 less than Caucasian ethnicity person. Yes, that's the dollar per hour is the unit here. So in this comparison, we can see that our automatically make COP or Caucasian ethnicity as the base category. And it was not shown here. And the other two, the estimate column here, and other two shows average difference between a Caucasian person and Hispanic person. The wage earned by a Caucasian versus a Hispanic person and wage earned by Caucasian versus other. But here, R has automatically made Caucasian as the base category. What if we want to find out how much more wage a Caucasian person earns compared to other category? We can reverse engineer it. We can make it other as the base category. And for that, we have used from forgets package fact underscore relabel. And giving this REE, that is reverse, that means other ethnicity, the last one ethnicity in this category becomes the base category now. And if we rerun the regression, now we can see that other category is not shown, other ethnicity is not shown because it is the base category, and Hispanic and Caucasian are shown. So here in this analysis, we can see that Hispanic person earns on average $0.77 less compared to others, and Caucasian earns $1.21 more compared to the others. So if the question asked is kind of changed, then we have to change the level of factors also. When our research question changes, we have to change the factor levels as well. That's it from my side for this presentation. If you want, we can also run model chapter also. But that I have prepared it half only. I have not covered yet the exercises.
Thank you for that, Maulik. That was really helpful.
And should we go ahead with the modeling chapter, or are you presenting something else?
No, I'm not on the schedule. Yeah. I don't have anything to present today. Is the model chapter is the next one, is it?
No, it isn't. But I wanted to present model. I was already preparing a presentation for the same, and even I want to present R markdown also. But that is, I think, the last three chapters in the book.
Which one is the next chapter that we are? I'm sorry, I was not there.
I will have to check it. I will actually have to check.
Okay. Maybe I think it would, if possible, make sense to go by sequence. So
yes.
Maybe we can ask in the group if someone is willing to take the next chapter.
Yes.
And then go accordingly.
Okay then.
I pinged Aditi, but I didn't hear from her.
Yes.
I think it's really chaotic time for to
right.
be able to stick to this book club. Yeah. So how about we post on the group and see what?
Definitely.
Okay.
We can post it.
Okay. Great.
So shall we meet now next week?
So maybe we can post in the group and see if someone volunteers for next week.
Now the chapter was function. The last chapter we presented was pipes, and now function would be the next chapter.
Okay.
And after function there is vector and iteration, so that would be map function from for PU triple R.
Okay.
And that is also quite interesting because in that we can run multiple regression equation, multiple processes at the same time. Simultaneous processing of different things.
Yeah.